Texas Podcast Massacre contains spoilers and adult language. For more horror, visit us at our website at texaspodcastmassacre.com. This is Texas Podcast Massacre.
Welcome to another episode of Texas Podcast Massacre, coming to you from Houston, Texas. I'm your host, Mitch, and with me, as always, are my fellow game masters, Lisa.
Please have a seat. Someone will be with you in a moment.
Okay. And Nate.
Escape the room.
Was a quote?
No, it was not. It was a general statement. It's 2019. Get on my back.
All right, escape this podcast.
Come on. You won't. There is no escaping.
You cannot win, actually. It's podcast. Literally impossible to win.
Perpetual hell.
Well, welcome to the perpetual hell that is Texas Podcast Massacre, where each week we take a look at a different horror movie with our unsuspecting victim, who is usually someone we would not call a horror fan. This week, we did an escape the room. We made it out. Our planned unsuspecting victim did not. It got a little too hot under the collar for that one.
How about over the collar?
Oh, so Lisa will be, as always, our unsuspecting victim, our victim.
Now, this is a little different because you are an escape room fan.
Fan is understating it. I mean,
I'm understating it? Fanatic?
And to be...
Enthusiast.
Yeah. Enthusiast.
Escape room enthusiast.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're a suspecting victim.
Yeah. So Lisa, how many roughly escape rooms do you think you've done?
What are you acting like I do them alone? You're with me in all of them.
How many have you done specifically?
How many have we
Lisa's
done?
Lisa's technically done more than me.
Oh, that's true.
Yeah. I've done a few without you.
But we, 15? Yeah, I know.
15? 20? What are we talking about here?
No, we're closer in the 50 range.
Whoa.
Yeah. And internationally.
You're the nerd guy in this movie is what you're saying.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I related to him hard at the beginning.
Yeah, only relatable character in this
one
movie.
One of the characters in the movie is like the nerd video game guy who's done a million escape rooms, escape the room the escape, etc.
escape the time to escape
all of them, prison break, all of that shit. And so you're that guy is what you're saying.
Oh yeah.
Wow. Yeah. So yeah, I think we all did it for Lisa's birthday party several years ago for the first time, and then we didn't do it again for like a year until we went to
Florence.
It was in Florence in Italy.
Italy.
Yeah.
Escape of the room.
Yeah.
Pretty much.
Was that really what it was?
No.
How many spaghetti-based puzzles were in this place?
Absolutely none. It was a Fettuccine.
I apologize.
World War II themed room.
You didn't get a hint unless you stood in front of the camera and did your arms and your hands in the Italian manner.
Dig through the spaghetti sauce to find the key.
They also didn't give you good hints if you did that.
Really? Okay.
No, we did one in Rome too. That was Escape the Vatican, which, you know.
Wow. All children ever.
only altar.
So that's great.
Amsterdam was zombies.
So. Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
So so what was your favorite? What was your, if you can describe your favorite escape room ever, since you're a fan. There's gotta be some standouts.
There's a few. Yeah. Florence was very good.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
It was very well done.
Yeah. Had a briefcase you had to carry around with you and plug into all the different stations.
Okay.
It was really good.
How many Leonardo da Vinci drawings are we talking about involved in this?
In the Rome one, several.
There were, really?
There were.
Are you serious?
There was one.
Yeah,
I think.
Cool.
For the escape.
Nice.
Yeah.
Nice.
A lot of them that have the secret. So a lot of them do have secret rooms. We're going to get into it because, Lisa, I think for this episode, I'm really curious your thoughts as a fellow escape room enthusiast, you know, how did the games really
escape
match
roomy,
up?
If you will?
Yes. Jesus.
Wow.
We're off to a great start.
This is a great start.
I'll tell you what, though. I think there's only one that we've been in that was almost as big as this one.
Yeah, we did one. It was in Phoenix, Arizona, which actually that had the other best one that at least I've done. It was a vampire room.
Is it a five roomer or what?
It was multiple, and it had like a drop bridge that goes underneath the floor to where you get to the vampire's like his coffin. And that's to escape. It wasn't an escape the room. It was you had to stab him in the heart.
Stab the room.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it was we got out in like with 8 seconds left.
Was it Lost Boys themed? Well, I mean, what are we talking about here?
No, I mean, it kind of almost looked more like Louisiana style.
Oh, so it was like Interview with the Vampire.
A little more, yeah, a little more Interview with the Vampire. True Blood. Although I did hum the Cry Little Sister song as we were running through the escape room.
Just escape.
It did not help us do better. We probably lost a lot of time. In fact.
That's awesome.
Yes.
Damn.
And I've only done 7 months pregnant. So
that was
fun.
I've only done one. So ever.
Really?
Yeah. Nailed it though. We crushed it. Never. It was like alchemy, sciency based one in Houston. So.
Okay.
Yeah.
Nice.
Well, there you go. Well, if you are an escape room enthusiast or if you've never done one and you think we're all a bunch of nerds, feel free to let us know at TexasPodcastMassacre@gmail.com. Also, you know, you can always find us on Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. Twitter, it's at whatever the hell we're
TX
at.
TX Pod Massacre. Jesus.
I have not logged into our Twitter in a while.
Yeah, I have.
I know you have. I'm more of the Facebook.
If someone's
Instagram.
Interacting with you on Twitter, it's me because Mitch is not doing it.
Sometimes it's me.
Nope.
It's you me. Can usually tell the it's when it's you or me.
And usually it's like, Nate's something great. And I'm like, you are correct.
Lisa doesn't do any of them because she refuses to spend more time on this podcast than her required.
However, I will say I do appreciate the odd comment here and there saying they agree with me because you guys are idiots. So thank you for that.
Hashtag Team Lisa. All right.
Yeah, always.
Well, with that said, we're going to move into our debate question of the week.
Boy, the next word that comes out of your mouth better be some brilliant fucking Mark Twain shit. Because it's definitely getting chiseled on your tombstone.
So in escape room, they go through.
Hold on. There are rooms you escape from. Can I just throw that out there?
Yes.
That's a thing.
Yes. There are rooms you escape
Lisa,
from.
Lisa, you are the expert. Did I describe that correctly? Like, is that a description that matches what happened?
Is that your description for the movie?
Rooms were escaped from.
Yeah.
Final answer.
I mean, sure. Not by everyone.
I want to phone a friend here.
Oh.
Now several of the rooms, we're going to get into several of the rooms and you know, the elaborate, I mean, the elaborateness of the puzzles and all that. Because some were decent.
But there was
one that I think we universally hated, which was the drug room. And we'll just get out. Basically, this room consisted of everyone, they touched something, which basically drugged them.
Whoa, spoiler. Jeez.
Well, we already hit the spoil, you know.
Yeah, no, I'm just kidding.
Oh, that's right. This is a new movie.
Yeah, who cares? Yeah.
You know what?
It's a new movie, but who gives a shit? It's escape room.
Yeah. Did you see Saw? You saw escape room.
Yeah, it's like, let's ruin the plot of Predator. Who gives a shit? There's a Predator. Come on. It's an escape room.
This
we
is
get
fair.
It.
This yeah. is fair. So, anyway, one of the puzzles, and I'm doing the air quotes, is that they get poisoned. And,
with drugs.
Yeah.
Hallucinogenic drugs.
And there's a limited number of antidote.
There's one.
Well, I was just going to say limited. So I don't totally.
Who gives?
I know.
This movie sucks.
Well, there you go. Thanks. Now, so here's my question. This room does suck. We all agree.
Yeah.
What would you replace this room with?
I am going to jump in here.
Get it.
What do we all love, excluding Lisa? Nicolas Cage movies.
Christ, and no.
Which Nicolas Cage movie would be the best escape room theme? I first thought National Treasure would be a good escape room.
You can't get like, out without the Declaration of Independence.
You have to decode the Declaration of Independence to get out of this room. I thought that would be great. But what is any? But this movie posits a reality or a company that will like murder you.
Mm-hmm.
And make you do more intense things, kind of Saw-esque almost,
sure,
to get out. So what's another Nick Cage movie that would be crazy enough to be an escape room? Wicker Man remake. If you want to escape the room, you got to go through the bees.
Not the bees!
You got to go through the bees. That's the end. The end is you have to go through a whole like bee tunnel to get out. You have to find the key in the honeycomb to get out.
There's only like one. There's one.
There's one mask. Exactly.
For, like, everyone.
Exactly. Mm. That. Oh my God. A Wicker Man bee themed room would be the pinnacle of the art form, in my personal opinion.
That is something.
And there's like a note that says not the bees. Like before you get into it, like. Like just because for no reason.
That
It'd be good.
That is devious.
It'd be good.
Yeah, that's
like it'd be like some sort
would
of.
You
like,
just, would you have random like screens or something, and Nicolas Cage would jump on going and just scream at you just randomly?
First of all, you could probably hire Nicolas Cage to be in this room. It's a possibility, but there's like some sort of like above the tunnel, there's like an A and then like an underline and then like a C. And then it's just, oh, what? B? That's weird. And then you go through the tunnel. Like, they're really lining it up for you, but you can't get out. You have to go through the B gauntlet to get out of this room. Boom.
So wait, you just have to go through, is there a puzzle though?
No, there's honeycombs to get keys out of.
Okay.
You have to find the beekeeper outfit, and there's only one.
Okay.
And so you have to get the group through on that. Obviously the bees aren't going anywhere, so it's kind of maybe there's some sort of honey based puzzle in the beginning. I was like, puddle puzzle. I don't even know what's happening, but it would be good.
That's a room.
It's a room.
Lisa.
It's a room. God, the room. Hold on. I'm sorry. There's got to be a room. The room.
Why don't you
escape the room?
Why don't you hold your horses there, partner?
There. Oh, did you take? Oh shit.
Yes.
Sorry. I apologize.
Well, that.
I apologize. Let's get into it.
The room. In my version, Tommy Wiseau is in the room with you.
He is personally with you. He's the game master, and he's
just
in the room.
And he's just commenting. Like, so there's some escape rooms where the person's actually in there watching you to give you the hints and all that. They don't have like an intercom system. They want to save money. And could you just imagine you're just like doing this like, ha ha ha, key's not there.
You think that's where the key is?
And the puzzle is just, it's in his pocket.
Yeah. Oh, hi, Clue.
Like, there's like a whole like tub of just spoons you have to dig through trying to find something. There's nothing in there. Just nothing but spoons.
There's a tape recorder. Oh my God. There's a party room where the party is happening. And before the party ends, you have to figure out where the atomic bomb is. Oh my God.
Exactly. However, the way out would be Tommy has the key. You have to tell him about your sex life.
Lisa, did he take yours and you're now looking up a new one?
No.
Okay, I'm just making sure that did not happen.
Escape the room.
Nicolas Cage versus Tommy Wiseau so far. You have a high bar to hit.
Mine sounds so dumb now. No, like, I can't even.
You have to go.
Well, you know, in this company, maybe. I'm sure everyone else on the internet will agree with you. Yours is probably like a rational one. What do you got?
So we've done a lot of these, and in a few of them, there have been parts where you have to defuse a bomb.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
A fake bomb, obviously. So
speed related.
I think one of the rooms should have been they had to defuse an actual bomb.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Lisa, when they were like, this is could actually fit in this movie, you and I were just like, let's just do some crazy shit.
Yeah.
Yeah.
An actual bomb?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What, do you have anything to compare it to? Like what? Like a movie that's similar or like the Hurt Locker level? What are we talking about here?
Sure.
Jesus.
Yeah, put on the whole outfit. Yeah.
So what are some of the puzzles you'll do with this one?
I don't know. I mean, there's going to be colored wires, so you got to figure out what order to cut the wires in. Mm-hmm,
mm-hmm, mm-hmm. It's like opaque clues about which wires to cut and which ones to
leave. Now, are they also drugged and, and tripping balls? No, okay, that's good.
What is your room called? So he had the room, escape the room.
And I had
escape the bees. So what is yours?
No, escape the cage.
Oh,
God. It was right there for you.
God.
Get in the cage.
Get out of the cage.
Get out of the escape the cage. God damn it. I shanked that. I apologize, listeners. I apologize.
Apologize to Nick Cage. He deserved better.
I will never do that.
So what would you call yours?
I don't know.
Don't blow up the room.
Don't blow up the room.
Well, there's a video game that's called Keep Talking and Nobody Explodes. You can just steal that name if you want.
Sure.
I mean, you know, you're already going to get arrested for
keep
murder.
Keep escaping if you get caught, and nobody explodes. Yeah, sure. There you go.
Yeah. Those are our rooms. So your options, everyone, are you can either get blown up by a bomb, get stuck in a room with Nicolas Cage and bees, or get stuck with Tommy Wiseau.
Well, no, it's not Nicolas. Well, Nicolas Cage is optional. It's just bees. Okay. Bees. Yeah, yours is just bees. Thing.
Mine is getting legitimately stuck with Tommy Wiseau. Wow. Which
well, the most awkward of the choices.
Well, I mean, why is this so Mark and Lisa,
cruel and unusual punishment?
Well, some things are worse. Some things are worse than being blown up.
Most
Lisa.
Of these rooms. Okay, so here's my question. Here's my question for you guys.
Mitch is last. It's between us at this point. Bees versus explosions. No, what do you got?
Here's my question. So, getting into the movie just slightly.
Sure.
Most of these rooms, except for the drug-induced room, had something to do with their backstory.
Yes.
Okay. Yeah.
Like so very intimately.
Obviously, known. If there's a real bomb, I can work in the backstory of some sort of veteran or something, right?
You bombed your spelling bee. So you have to spell words wow. correctly or the bomb goes off. That would be awesome. And it also is bee related. So it comes from my room to your room.
Well, that's
Mitch,
what I was saying.
You are excluded. We both win.
What are the bees go to the spelling bee.
No, the bee goes to the spelling bee. Oh, that's over. It's over. You're done.
What? What is...
You get out of the bees, like, oh my God, we're done with bees. Thank goodness. Now it's a spelling bee until you explode?
Well, yeah.
That's good.
So
that's
one,
real good.
One person has to be allergic to bees, but there's someone else before they realize that their backstories are all connected.
This isn't my girl, okay?
Well, calm I'm just
down.
Saying no.
Calm down.
Because they all have backstories that all connect to the puzzles. But if you got two people, one who's allergic to bees, one who bombed their spelling bee, they get to the bee room and both of them are thinking, if they haven't communicated, they're both like, oh, that was my room. Okay, good.
I like how in this debate, you've already foregone your entire answer. And you just go with our answer. I like that better.
Well, because for me, the backstory is you are Mark or Lisa. You're back in this. You're back on set with this guy.
Sure. So the winner is bees. Can we agree on that?
No.
Just bees generally are the winners.
The winner is everyone who does not have to do this podcast right now.
As always. Right. Well, let us know which room you would want to be stuck in, or if you have a better room than ours, which is a low
green
bar.
Room. Yeah. Previous episode, green room.
Check it out.
Slightly better than some of these rooms.
That was another literal escape room.
Yeah, exactly.
It was. All right. Well, let's get into this week's movie of the week, Escape Room.
Little boxes on the hillside. Little boxes made of ticky tacks.
They're watching us. They know every move that we're making.
There's a blue box.
They knew everything about us.
This is my hospital bed.
Me too.
They made these rooms for us.
Have you ever seen things that weren't there before?
I am not imagining this.
Surviving is a choice. Yep.
I want
to
let me out of here. Yep.
That's why they chose us.
And they all look just the same.
My God, this movie. All right, so escape room, Lisa. For all the unsuspecting victims, how are you pitching this? How are you telling people?
This is a pretty self-explanatory one.
Nate already said it.
Well, no, go.
A group of unsuspecting victims get lured to an escape room to compete for a $10,000 prize.
Oh. Wow, that was very energetic, first of all. I just want to say that.
Well, that's about as much effort as anyone put into the premise for this movie.
There's the daredevil lady. Come on.
That's what I'm saying. How did they get her to do this movie?
Like, hey, she goes, well, Daredevil got canceled.
I don't know. Maybe this is she signed a contract with, maybe it was back when she was doing True Blood and maybe she still had some years left to HBO or something.
Mm-hmm. I never saw True Blood. Damn it. Mm-hmm.
Okay. Yeah, she's in True Blood.
Well, is that Rogue? Rogue's in True Blood, right?
What? Oh, yes.
Thank you.
Yeah, Sookie Stackhouse. Yes.
Rogue. Okay.
Sookie.
So she went from True Blood to Daredevil. And it's like, oh, Daredevil got canceled because all the Marvel shows are getting canceled on Netflix. I'll do escape room. That's the level of what's happening.
Unless
right?
they filmed this like 10 years ago and just not releasing it.
No, I don't know.
I think it was recent. I feel
like this is a, I signed a contract for two movies. I did one and then they just like, hey, we need, you're doing this one. All right.
Okay. All right.
yeah, that's pretty much it. That is entirely the premise. I mean, it is
escape rooms. That's it.
So Nate, what do you want to tell us about this one?
This movie came out. This is our first 2019 movie. PG-13 rated. It was a tight 99 minutes. Seems a little long for this one. The director was Adam Robitaille. You might remember Adam Robitaille from the classic movie. And by classic, I mean not classic. The Taking of Deborah Logan. Remember the movie with the really red-faced girl poster? No. There's that one, and there's last year's.
I'm looking that up now.
There's last year's Insidious, The Last Key. So he did the fourth Insidious movie, and then this year he
like
the
one that explains it.
The one we didn't see. Oh, okay.
Yeah,
I've seen the. I know you're talking about the Taking.
Yeah,
of
it's the one with the red face poster of the lady. Like yes. It's the only thing is I remember.
Lisa, would you like to see this?
I watched it. Look at this poster. Look at this poster, Lisa.
No.
Is this movie you want to see? Look at this.
I'm not looking.
Look at this.
No.
It's like, wow.
It's very late at night. I have to go to bed.
Damien really became a woman overnight here.
Don't show her that shit.
no. Yeah,
so that's the director of this movie. I want to ask you guys. So this movie is still in theaters. We just saw it recently.
Surprisingly.
What?
Because that Possession movie that came out right at the end of last year was out in like a week.
It doesn't matter. This is the first 2019 horror film.
No. I just mean that this was actually still... It's going. I would not have expected this one to still be in
theaters. It's going. I want to know what you guys think. So I'm gonna tell you this. The budget for the movie was $9 million. But what was the opening weekend? How many million dollars are we talking about here?
$1 million
opening weekend.
No, I'm going to say it made, I'm going to go at 3.5. That feels a little.
So the budget of the movie was $9 million.
Yeah. I mean,
opening weekend, we got, and this came in number two of all movies behind Aquaman, $18.23 million.
Goddamn.
People were bored or something.
People are doing this. And as of our recording, we're up to almost $34 million domestic.
Can't wait for Escape Room 2.
$37 million worldwide. We are getting an Escape Room 2. It is happening.
This
movie is doing surprisingly well. Not unlike Aquaman. So Aquaman is number one. Escape Room number two is...
Because it's a buzzword. Escape rooms. Those things are cool. Let's go see this movie.
But normally you don't release horror movies in January, like the beginning of January. And yet, here we are, and it did.
Hocus got released in June.
Well, I was going to say, $9 million is a pretty up there budget for a horror movie. Yeah.
And they got it back double opening weekend. So this is probably going to be happening. We're probably going to do an Escape Room 2 in a couple of years. So.
You mean a couple months on VOD?
Couple months. Okay.
They already filmed it.
Straight to DVD Escape the Room 2. Oh, we're probably going to be doing that soon. But yeah.
Escape to the Room with the 2 and the numeral. Oh, man.
But yeah, there you go. So this movie is doing pretty damn well. Like I mentioned before, I would say the most notable person in the movie is probably Amanda Harper, who's the actress who played Deborah, who was in Daredevil. Probably the most memorable, biggest actor or actress, right? Of the whole movie, I could say.
No, did you say Amanda Harper's her character? Her name's Deborah Ann Wolfe.
Oh, sorry. I flipped that. Yes. Sorry. Debbie played Amanda. There you go.
Debbie does Amanda
in this movie. Pretty well, I would say, generally. She is probably the most famous person in the whole movie. Can we agree on that? I don't think I knew anyone else.
I would say she's most. I think, Lisa, you remember Tyler Labine. He's from Tucker and Dale versus Evil.
That's true. He's
but I wouldn't say he's as famous as.
Yeah, and he was in Deadbeat on Hulu, which is a good show everyone should watch. But yeah, other than that, those are probably the two people I know at all.
Yeah, I don't.
Anyone else?
I didn't know anyone else.
I don't know anyone else at all.
No, that was it.
Well, that's how you only make a movie for $9 million instead of a lot more. So there you go.
Did like 8 million go to Deborah?
No, 8 million went to the rooms.
Yeah.
A half fair. A million went to Daredevil Lady, and then the other half million went to everyone else.
Fair. Okay.
You know, the marketing and promotion for this movie should have been like, can you escape? And they should have actually just had people go through the set.
Like, oh, okay.
Yeah, well, you know,
okay.
It's funny. When they did...
Like Blair Witch, like, this is a real thing.
Well, you know, when they did It, they actually did a pop-up, like, little haunted house thing in L.A., where you'd go through different rooms and all. It was more of a haunted house thing. I'm surprised they wouldn't do, like, a pop-up...
Escape room.
Yeah. Not authentic. Should have been in Maine, first of all. Kind of the whole opposite part of the country, so negative for me. Secondly, this happens in... it's from a little city in the Midwest. I don't know if you heard of it. It's called Chicago, Maine. And I was pleased that this whole movie was basically an advertisement for Chicago. So.
Oh, yeah. It was
pretty happy
really,
about
really
that.
Hit up the tourism board
pretty
there.
Pretty happy about that. I'm assuming they funded half the movie. The city of Chicago. Just like, Rahm Emanuel's like, look, I know, really love
you
know,
well, you went back up near Chicago.
I was in Chicago. Literally less than a week ago.
Yeah. So you should have just gone and done this on location.
There you go.
Hard pass. Hard. If someone sends me like a cube that's telling me like, oh, figure this cube out to get somewhere. I'm like, fuck you. If I had to figure out a cube to get somewhere.
Oh my gosh. No, don't get me started on the cube.
No, thank you.
Those damn puzzle boxes.
Well, let's get you started on the cube. So let's look, a lot of the opening of this movie is really dumb filler that doesn't really make any difference to the movie. So I'm going to suggest.
But let me tell you this one thing. Uh-huh. Everyone gets sent a cube.
Yeah.
It's a puzzle box they'd figure out. You know what movie's better than this movie? Cube. There's a movie called Cube. It's fucking good. And it's an escape room-esque room. It's better than this movie. Come on, do a sphere.
No.
Do a triangle. Don't do a movie that's better than you already. Like, stop it.
I was about to say, I enjoyed this part better when it was called Hellraiser. And they figure out the puzzle box and then the Cenobites show up.
Boxes, yeah. Do a different shape. Okay.
So yeah.
What about an oval? Oh, escape the oval. Oh, that sounds fantastic to me.
So each of these people is, I mean, it's like a really shit. It's like a non-email phishing attack. Each of these people are sent a box, presumably from someone they know. Yeah. And they're just like, hey, just thought you might like this, even though we've never talked about any of your interests or hobbies at any point in your life. Here's this random puzzle box.
Lisa,
can you figure it out?
Tell me this. If I sent you a puzzle cube, what would you think? Like, just
I'd probably try and solve it.
You would try to, you would, okay. So I
wouldn't go said you, where it said to but go, but I'd still try and solve it.
So you wouldn't go a place.
No.
What if you figured it out and there was a address?
No, because I mean, I need a website. I need Yelp reviews. I don't just go, you know.
But there were Yelp reviews because this,
I need a Groupon.
The guy searched it and they said, this is like the best escape room ever. They did have a website. So would you have gone there maybe?
Yeah, but definitely didn't have Yelp reviews.
I might have got her then if I sent that.
Fun fact, Mitch and I wanted to do an actual escape room after we saw the movie, but we couldn't make the timing work out.
Oh,
yeah.
Come on. Like, I've learned so much. I've done my research after this movie.
Right, we're ready.
Yeah.
We saw plenty of their mistakes. Getting a random puzzle box and then an invitation like, hey, you're cordially invited because you're able to solve this. Even though I don't think one dude solved it. He was hitting it with a hammer and then it's just like, just fuck it.
The
here.
One guy looked at YouTube. The one guy solved it with YouTube.
Yeah.
What the fuck is that? Yeah. Oh, don't get me started on that guy.
Yeah, so let's talk about some of these characters. So when they all end up showing up. Let's just get to where they get to.
Character is generous.
the people that are in this escape room. Sure. There are six of them.
Yeah.
So there is, I don't remember their names.
Doesn't matter. Let's go with the tropes. Let's go with the tropes.
There is shy, quiet girl who's going to break out of her shell from this. Yeah.
Zoe. Yes.
So she's the one on the ad cover, basically. There is a ruthless Wall Street trader, win at all cost guy.
Jason.
Yep. Then there is person with deep, mysterious past who's very cold and edgy.
Ben. Yeah. The smoker.
No, Amanda.
Oh, Amanda. Oh, she's the soldier.
Does no, but you don't know she's soldier. That's like later on. You just know that she's like she's got burn stuff and everything. Well, because at first I thought she was a burn victim. I mean, she is, but
she's both.
Well, but she was reading an article in the newspaper. It doesn't matter.
Okay.
If I met, I was, so there you go. I was met Amanda.
The edgiest one was Ben.
Was he really edgy?
The grocery store worker who smoked everywhere. Yes.
No, he was just the hoodlum is what I would.
There's a guy who does all the dad jokes, Mike.
Yeah.
The guy from Tucker and Dale vs. Evil.
I'm going to go ahead and tell you, Mike's the MVP to me.
And there's the nerd guy, Danny, who's playing on his phone, done all the escape rooms like Lisa. So basically you're an Indian guy. Just heads up on this movie.
Well, so here is hint number one, that this is not a legit place. You never sign a waiver, which if you're straight up planning on murdering someone, I would definitely make them sign the waiver. I'd say what I would do differently.
Michael Myers is going to the babysitter. Hey, can you sign this waiver real quick?
Thanks. I'm just saying, it's like, because if someone ever does escape, you don't want them to be like, I'm suing your ass. You'd be like, no, you signed this waiver. It's your fault. You knew the risk.
Never escape the lawyers. Escape the room. All right. Yeah, that's true.
And
yeah.
You know, no one reads those things.
Exactly.
So it could have a clause in there. You could die. And no. We're not responsible.
You die and we digitize your likeness in an app that then we use to make money.
Yeah. So of these characters, I'll tell you, Mike, the truck driver dad dude, he incredible. He's an MVP, and we'll go through it as we get through
dad
these rooms.
Jokes all over the place.
All over the place. And he actually solves the majority of a lot of the puzzles outside of him and Zoe having these like shinnings.
Zoe is like the ADHD shinning person.
Yeah, basically she's Sheldon, but less annoying.
Which is, again, have you guys seen Cube?
No.
Fucking watch Cube, because basically this movie ripped off Cube like hard. The Cube is like a sci-fi very independent sci-fi horror movie from like the late 90s. Mm-hmm. Fucking watch that movie. There's been three or four of them.
Okay.
But they are good and way better than this, but the same premise.
Excellent.
So. All listeners, watch Cube.
The more you know. Dun, yeah. Dun, 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 dun. All right, so Lisa, what about you? Was there a character you enjoyed or you were rooting for? Or
I kind of like the quiet girl,
the main girl,
yeah,
Zoe,
final girl,
yeah, because yeah, I feel like I'm take her approach when I do an escape room.
Leave me the F alone.
So you're the person in the corner. Is like the names are the same. The male has the name. Like, that's you. Like, you're just, like, softly saying, like, this is the clue. Like, that's you? Is that what you're saying?
No, but she recognized a lot of the puzzles before anyone else did.
Oh, saying you're smarter than everybody. That's what you're saying. That's what you're saying.
Pretty much.
That's awesome. And yet you're on this podcast. But that's fine. Okay. So, but Zoe's the main marketed person in the movie.
Yes.
Who did you... All right, so Lisa, you like Zoe. Who did you hate the most?
Well, wait, who did you like?
No, I want to hear who she hated the most first.
I don't know. That's a good question.
Well, who did you hate starting off? Because, you know, toward the end, it's pretty clear there's...
end, I mean, they kind of thin out people, obviously. People... Yeah. You know, die they, during some of the
some things. People turn heel
in the beginning.
The end
like, you know,
I honestly, you know, we say we relate to Danny, the nerd guy, a lot, but
oh, you hated him.
I got really fed up with it real quick because he's this is the most immersive crap
so
ever.
Realistic.
I'm like, you are going to die.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. He walked on that screen. You're like, oh, yeah.
You're going to get immersed in flames if you don't start getting your shit together.
For doing so many of these, like he said he did, he never picked up on anything.
Yeah, he was not good.
There was a single thing he solved before he died.
No, I don't think so either.
So I'm like, what the hell, man?
I think at the very beginning, he got one thing, like T's as
and
part
peas,
of
Danny.
A thing. But yeah, it was not a T's and peas.
T's and peas.
I hate that.
That's why we're going to keep doing it every episode.
So my favorite person was obviously the war-torn, burned Amanda. She was the best, in my opinion.
Why?
Well, she got over her fears to get through the first room, which was nice. So everyone's got a backstory flashback kind of thing that, and all the rooms are tied to them because of reasons we'll get to at the end, but there's reasons kind of that are pretty fantastical, which make no sense, but that's fine. But no, she gets over her fear and she actually sacrifices herself for the group, which I appreciate. And she fucking had some arms. She's talking like monkey barring and jumping across shit. Like,
okay.
Like crazy.
That is awesome. The weirdest phrase.
It's awesome.
She had some arms.
She got arms. Michelle Obama-esque is what I'm talking about.
She was never
going
to make it though, because you can't, we watched enough Ninja Warrior. If you're going to get across that pool table, you can't have your arms extended all the way. You got to keep that
she
tension.
She wasn't efficient with her arm strength enough.
You got to keep those muscles engaged. Now,
you know what? Sure. But she went for it. And I appreciated that.
No,
so
yeah.
I liked it. So I liked her.
Yeah.
She was my favorite.
Who was your least favorite at the beginning?
Grocery store bitch. That guy was the worst.
Yeah.
I'm edgy. I'm smoking. Who gives a shit? You're all going to die.
Basically everyone I've ever met from Chicago.
not me.
And he was the only one.
I don't smoke.
You don't smoke.
No,
I guess the only difference.
Dude, he's from fucking Aurora, like a suburb or some shit. He's from Barrington up north.
I don't know. We no don't one get, knows what that is.
I do. He's from Schaumburg. Who gives a shit? Palatine. I've gone for a long time.
Oh, I'm glad you can. No, yeah, I mean, you know, I agree with both of y'all. They were both terrible. There wasn't really anyone I was like, I didn't hate, to be honest, in this one.
Wow, there's no one you liked.
No.
Not even, what about with the old dad guy?
Oh, wait, I did like Mike.
You liked him. There you go.
Sorry.
And you like right. Mike. You want to be like Mike.
I want to be like Mike. Okay, Mike is great.
Yeah.
Damn shame. So let's talk about the first room. So the first room, the fire room, which is one that most everyone has seen from the trailer.
We don't need no water.
Let this motherfucker burn.
Exactly.
Agreed. So on the nose with the Fahrenheit.
Burning down the room.
Yeah.
Classic Talking Heads song. I can do a lot of these. I'm not going to.
I did at least enjoy the puzzle. I liked the fact that one piece of it was, turning into an oven effectively.
Yeah.
And there was only enough water to fill six glasses.
That was very
so
good.
When someone drank, you're like, oh shit. Somebody gonna die.
This is a very Saw-esque move because as Lisa figured out last year, don't ever get rid of water because in the very beginning of Saw, they had the key go down the drain,
mm-hmm.
which fucked them over. Leave the water where it is.
They never could find that magnet.
Had they listened to that podcast episode, they'd have been fine.
Water is useful. Never get rid of water. Is like a universal conduit. Do not get rid of it in any way, ever, in an escape room. Have you guys ever had a water-based escape room thing?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm. Several.
Like what?
There was one room where we had to water a plant,
mm-hmm.
and that triggered something to pop open. There was one room where I think we had to pour water in to get something to float up so that we could get to it.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. So
if you were to drink that water, that would have been a negative, right?
Yeah, we'd go and drink
that
water.
Yeah, I think that one was in Amsterdam, so it was definitely laced with LSD.
Yeah. Actually, okay, the canal water in Amsterdam is cleaner than the drinking water we have here. That is a fact. They test it.
Once again, the more you know.
So yeah, we've had several water-based clues.
Okay.
Yeah.
So don't fuck with water is the general premise. And they fuck with the water.
Here's my issue with the first room. It only what do y'all remember what actually precipitated the room actually starting?
The door handle got pulled.
Yeah, because they went to go open the door. Had they just sat there forever? I mean, it would have been hours before they got started.
Just waiting for somebody?
Yeah.
Yeah, the planning of some of these rooms was
what if the door never like and what if the door never shut all the way like firmly? You know, you could just all leave and be like, all right, never mind.
Well, then you win. you don't die, which is winning. So yeah. There's a lot of presumptions made by this
game
escape room
designer.
Company.
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Yep. So
but I like this first room. I thought the puzzles were good. Now the second room. So first room, for you keeping the score, everybody makes it.
Yeah.
We're doing good. It's PG-13.
Doing well, some would say.
The second room was dumb.
It wasn't even a room, really.
It was a room for about
5 seconds.
It was just the northern exposure room.
The second that we saw it mentioned, we're like, Rudolph.
Yeah.
The clues were easy. The thing about this movie that really sucked balls, if I can rant for like a couple seconds here, is that they never paused on the clues enough for you to get it. They always cut to the clue.
Yeah.
Like, let the person figure it out. Like, you want people yelling at the screen like, oh my God, it's the fucking thing behind you. They never do that. They cut so fast. No one can ever figure that shit out. So you would rather
them have kind of panned around the room.
Slow pans around the room so you can figure out the shit yourself and get some sort of accomplishment. And it's like, oh, that fucking bitch was singing Rudolph the Reindeer when some fucking car crashed with a million of his friends and they all died, but he was alive. Like, I don't care. I would like to see like this, like a unfiltered view at first to get kind of a lay of the land to figure out that, like, I got that. Like, I saw this thing happen here, but they never did that. They cut to it so fast. Yep. It really ruined a lot of like the problem solving that an escape room, that's the whole point of the escape room, and that you weren't really part of the experience. You were just kind of seeing other people solve it really fast. Like, oh, I put my hand in this thing, but like you never saw like the inside of the mouth. Like there's a key in there. Like you never could
be part of it.
We weren't really part of the experience, which kind of sucked.
When they're in the, I remember when they were in the cabin in the very first part of this particular room, I remember thinking my review for this movie was going to just be, hey, you know how much fun it is to go to an escape room and watch other people do puzzles?
Exactly. That's what I'm saying. So like, if you could be part of the experience, like that would be a million times better.
Now, I think it got a little, I think it got a little better with some of the other room, some of the other parts. But in that room, I agree. Cause then it's just like, they're just randomly shouting things. Like, that
obvious for like minutes. Yeah. It was just, it was unnecessary. Now the ice. Now
here's my question. You open the door and it's like, oh, hey, it's we're fucking Alaska up here. I would have just grabbed a coat out of the cabin before I walked out.
The cabin had a lot of shit in it. There's a lot of shit.
It had a lot of shit. And they just all like stumble on out and then the door's locked.
A piece of wood. Like you could have grabbed anything from the fire.
And it's not like they're not suspicious at this point because the other room exploded into flames.
Now, is this your least favorite room? So I'm from up north. So cold temperatures, not as foreign to me. You guys, straight south.
Oh, I would love the cold.
Oh, you love the cold?
Yes.
Wow.
Lisa? You could have lived in that room.
Lisa, yeah.
Oh, 20 degrees? Live that room? Fuck you. There's no way you can live in that room.
I don't have to. Jesus. Obviously.
20 degrees.
No, I just don't want to have to shovel snow. That's why I don't like the north.
Okay.
But I want the cold. Like here. I know. I want the cold.
Lisa, how would you do in this room? What's your cold tolerance?
Would have been awful.
You would have been like real, like early. You've been grabbing the coat early.
Yeah.
Okay.
It would have been terrible.
True Texans and Southerners would have died immediately stepping out into that cold.
That's what I'm saying.
Based on how people react here when it drops to like 50.
Like people are wearing that coat, like that like Coast Guard level coat at 55. Like that happens here.
Yeah.
And that is, first of all, insane.
Yes.
And so I literally at 55, I'm wearing shorts and flip flops. Which I wore, that was the temperature which this movie I went to go see, shorts, flip-flops.
Yep. Yeah, but how do you do in the heat?
I do great. Our thermostat is set at 80 in the summer.
No, 80. Yeah. How do you do when it's 105?
I do fine. Mm. I do fine. I'm pretty versatile. I'm versatile.
We forgot, Nate.
This is, again, more, now you get to know more about
our thermostat in the summer for air conditioning is at 80. So, like, we don't mind. We don't mess around, man. We go low.
Nate's
gonna
just spontaneously combust one day.
Yeah, it's fine.
T's and P's, Nate.
You know,
T's and P's.
First of all, I hate that.
Poor Danny.
Please, if any of you are thinking of reviewing this podcast, want to give us, you know, whatever stars, make sure leave on a comment T's and P's, Nate. That's really all I want.
That would make me furious. So if you want to make me furious, go do that.
I just want to see nothing but T's and P's, Nate, everywhere, all over, on everything.
Toilets and papers. Is that what it is? I don't know.
No. So anyways, they get locked outside. Here's where Mike's the man. He's the most observant. He notices there's a wolf looking up this way.
He's an ice fisher.
Climbs up a tree. He's an ice fisher. He solves these. He basically rescues this whole group, except for our first casualty, Daniel's son, who I guess the ice around him explodes inexplicably, and he falls
that,
in.
First of all, that was some fucking bullshit.
Yeah, that's
ice exploding to kill somebody
because he had a lighter.
That
with
is
him.
Some hot trash.
Yeah,
that's a garbage move. You should let the room be as is and not be manually controlling. Yeah. That really.
Yeah, your security guard should have done a better job of collecting everyone's personal items if you didn't want anyone to bring in anything.
But there's no cell phone signal anyway, so it didn't even matter. Yeah. Now, when your spirit animal guy died, how did you feel, Lisa? How did you feel?
Meh.
Oh, no. Because that was the guy that you said was closest to you.
Yeah, but I told you that's also he started to get on my nerves when he was like, oh, this is so awesome. I'm like, you're going to die.
And so he's the closest to you, but you're like, I don't care anyway.
Yeah.
Because I feel like I would have taken it seriously from the very first time I started to get hot.
But do you think in the future that guy would have been helpful? Like, do you think more people would have survived if that guy
survived? Because he didn't do anything up to that point.
Okay, so you think he was just worthless from the get-go.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Yeah. Good riddance, Danny.
Pretty much.
Yep. Yeah. Done.
So they do the rest of them escape. The third room is the billiard room, which they also see in the trailer.
Now, very Clue-esque, but I loved it. Upside down.
Yes.
That was awesome.
Yeah, that was.
Best room by far.
Best room design. I agree. The floors falling out was an interesting.
I loved it.
Yeah.
But there was an edge to hang on to.
Now, I got to tell you, when we do escape rooms and there's those sliding tile puzzles, I go straight to that and I take that over because I love those puzzles. So the fact that there was that one with records and all that was pretty legit. So
the fact that the colors match the billiard ball, like that was a classic.
Escape room puzzle. Yeah. Well thought out, well done. That room, if you had paid money to go do that room on your own, but, you'd have been happy with
but
that.
But like the main character, how much quantum physics do you know? Because apparently that was integral to solving this puzzle to her. Quantum physics.
Well, I dabble in quantum physics in my off time.
You do dabble in quantum physics.
No, I don't think it's necessary.
Okay, fine.
I think I don't know what any of that had to do with anything.
They were entangled together.
Oh my God. Oh. So, yeah, I mean, there's not a whole lot to this room. It's really just it's the sliding tile puzzle. Well, which
Amanda,
gives them the billiard pool numbers.
Amanda shows off her arms.
Yeah.
A lot of people almost fall in.
She's in like spider, like lawn
exactly,
position.
That's
the
what
whole
I'm saying.
Time.
She's American Ninja Warrior, like you were saying, for sure. But other people were like, oh, every time the floor falls. So when you know that, get off the floor. Is that that hard? Like they were surprised every time.
Didn't climb fast enough.
Climb
for my
something
liking.
Every time. The thing is, if there were clues on the floor level, then fine. There were no clues there.
No.
None. Yeah. Get off the floor.
The floor is lava.
The floor is lava. Get the fuck out when this song stops playing. It's done. More lava is added. She was great. So there's she does a safe. She gets an eight ball. She drops it while she's American Ninja Warring inefficiently, according to Lisa. And then she drops down the floor, throws it transmagically underhanded. Very rookie of the year-esque underhand throw.
Yeah.
What's his name? Sideways thrower?
Tebow?
Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That's what it reminded me of.
It was more of a rookie of the year throw, but I'll take Tim Tebow. It's like
he's playing baseball now. It all tracks.
He's in the outfield. But no, and then she plummets to her death.
Yeah.
That was
very sad because she did a very obvious sacrifice for everyone else, which was appreciated.
Mm-hmm.
Not by the main guy. That guy did not appreciate it.
Oh yeah, the Wall Street trader dude.
Yeah, yeah. Jason.
That guy was. He's the worst. Not sitting around mourning anyone's death.
No, which is good until you start trying to murder people.
Well,
a negative.
Here's the thing. He kind of gets a bad rap for this and this, but he also just met these people, presumably 2 hours ago.
So the thing about him was good is that in the first fire thing, he went ahead.
Yeah.
To the unknown. That's useful. So when he goes through and he calls back, he's being kind of selfish, but it's useful for the group. Yeah. Because they know he did not die in some vent related murder accident.
Because let me tell you,
so that was good. He did some stuff.
Because let me tell you, when you do these escape rooms, if you don't plan it right, or if you're paying a shit ton of money, because the good thing about like in Europe and some places that you can do it just two people, or and it's easy to book a room. Yeah. Here in America, most of the rooms are like, you book it, and if you don't fill up the room, anyone can join in. So you could do a room with a bunch of strangers. And let me tell you, I've done a room or two with strangers.
Fuck strangers.
I wanted to murder them.
It drives us crazy.
You know what? If I had...
Now, hold on.
Maybe he's the most relatable guy.
Hold on. Who out of you two would murder someone faster in a real escape room? If you had to pick, so Mitch versus Lisa.
Like other people in the room with
us? Yeah, like who's going to be this guy who tries to like murder other people to get ahead? Who is going to be that person?
Ooh. I don't know.
Ooh.
I don't think it would be Lisa.
So that, hold on.
So that means you.
There's, yes. There's only two people, Mitch.
I would, because I would probably get so frustrated because I'm very competitive in these things.
It's not like a premeditated, it's more like a frustration murder.
Like
in the heat of the moment.
Because it's gonna be one of those things where someone found a fucking like key or a rolled up paper or something, put it in their pocket, didn't tell anyone, and then you're sitting here for 20 minutes, time's ticking, and they're like, oh, hey, there's this thing. And you're just like, I
could see Lisa like planning that on someone to get you to murder someone that everyone hates you. And then she goes forward more. Like I could see that occurring.
Lisa, here's the thing. Lisa, right?
I could see that happening.
I don't see Lisa doing that. I see Lisa just solving the puzzle and then she's going to solve it. And she's just going and she's not going to tell you necessarily.
You're the Zoe.
If you don't keep up,
you're Zoe.
You're dead.
You're Zoe.
That is, yeah. That's
we got to play outside the system.
Lisa's just Zoe.
Okay. She's just doing her shit and you just better tag along or you're lost. Me, I will try to cooperate, and then I will inevitably want to murder someone.
Okay,
I will just be filled with rage of hall.
So the next room,
is where we start on the decline.
The
of
hospital room, and this is where it really goes down.
So this is where they try. This is where they try to like say, oh, this is why it's all connected. And
there's
everyone,
a file for everybody.
Yeah, they're
and,
all
and a bed because you've all been in the hospital.
They're all traumatic survivors.
Hey, you know what? Everyone's been in the hospital in their life. Every single person ever has been to the hospital at some point.
Well, but not in a hospital bed.
What do you mean? Not. Oh, have you ever been born before? You're welcome. I was just there. I was just there a couple months ago. Everyone has been in a hospital bed when they were born.
You are not the person in the bed that they have the charts for. Dumbass.
But someone else was who was born.
Not,
you're welcome.
No, your baby is not it. That. There wasn't a bunch of fucking cribs sitting around there.
Yeah, there were. It was in our room. You're welcome.
You had to go for your kidney stone.
Same room.
I did have to go for my kidney stone.
Oh, you're welcome. And you're welcome. Well, That's right.
I just didn't spend the night.
I didn't know what it was.
Lisa, you've been in a hospital bed before?
Well, when she gave birth.
There you go. That's what I'm saying.
No, that only works for women.
It works for people who are born also.
No, because they're not admitted at the hospital.
Anyway, it's stupid. Let's just get back to it.
It was all because they're all survivors.
You said you've never been trapped in a coal mining accident. That's what you're telling me right now.
No, I'm not. I'm not from West Virginia.
I only know the country road song.
I don't know.
So everyone's a sole survivor.
Yeah.
Not unlike John Denver. But everyone's sole survivor. Fire survivor, coal mine survivor.
Yeah.
Like two person boat cab size survivor, which is pretty lame, first of all. That's a lame one. There's two people and you survive out of two people. That's like almost nothing. The other lady was a plane crash survivor, right? That was a good one.
Danny.
They knew he would die. They didn't even give him a thing.
No, they did because she found his folder.
Carbon monoxide poison.
No, I know.
That's what it was.
I know, but that's basically like the cop out of anything.
Mesothelioma.
Yeah, exactly. Like he's like, you have like restless leg syndrome. That was the level of Danny's involvement. Yeah. Like you have literally the worst thing ever. Like it didn't matter. I don't know.
Yeah.
I bought a new house recently and I have two carbon monoxide detectors. So just heads up.
So you definitely don't want to end up like Danny.
I do not want to end up like Danny.
His was the least traumatic then.
Yeah. Well, his family died.
His was.
He was the only one that survived to his family. Hey.
Who gives a shit? It was garbage. It was garbage.
Yeah, this is, I didn't,
what an afterthought.
You know what? It's okay if they just are just random fucking people stuck in a room together.
It's like, cool like that too. Oh, you're a survivor because you were with your friend and he jumped off a cliff and he hit his head and died. Like, that's what the one guy's survivor was. It was two people. Who cares?
So, okay. So let's talk about the puzzle. So the puzzle is a video that shows up with the doctor, Dr. Toucan Sam. or what is it? Do y'all remember the doctor's name?
Yeah,
is
Wu Tan Yu. It's an anagram.
Dr. Toucan Sam. Classic anagram, which spells, I don't know what I'm talking about.
You see, this is how we are in escape rooms.
Yeah. So, yeah.
I say escape.
So far, I still don't actually write. So I think that's Foghorn Leghorn. That is the wrong bird. God damn it, Nate. All right. So the video comes on and it's talking about you got to reach your limit or something and
push it to the limit.
Yeah. Basically, they have to EKG one another for some reason. I don't know. I didn't get this puzzle.
Yeah. It was like Casino
Royale. It wasn't really a puzzle.
It was like Casino Royale, but way worse.
Yeah.
Like, it was way worse.
Yeah. So poor Mike eats it here because he's out of shape.
He offers to have his heartbeat go over like 200 beats per minute.
Well,
like,
he didn't offer.
No, he offered it the first time. And then like two more times happened. But the first time he did offer it.
And then Wolf of Wall Street over there just like zaps the shit out of him until he basically goes to the cardiac
arrest. Wolf of Wall Street goes like straight zen. Like, I can control my own. It's like in like Flint. I think you guys seen that movie. But he can control his own heartbeat. So he looks like he's dead. That's what this guy does. Really? Come on. Oh, I was on an ice boat one time. I know how to lower my heartbeat to like 50 beats per minute. Said no one ever in the history of Earth, but sure.
It was a dumb puzzle. Meanwhile, Zoe is like smashing all the cameras.
Well, according to this logic, Vikings have a heartbeat of like 40 beats per minute, apparently. They're in the cold all the time. They're on boats. They can do whatever they want.
The more you know.
All right. So,
Okay, so
Mike's dead. Zoe, because she's not helping anyone solve the room.
She goes rogue.
Poison fills the room and she dies. And then
she spends her time knocking out cameras.
Yeah.
Instead of like doing the, the paddles to get them.
If I'm running a murder escape room, maybe I'm putting those cameras higher than where you can reach them.
Nah, that's too easy. Too easy, Mitch. Come on.
They got to set these things up and tear them down quick.
We only have enough resources to know all about everyone's life story, but not enough for camera placement, obviously.
Right.
Come on.
So the next room is the drug room. We already talked about it. Effectively,
they both touch a
porthole or something.
It's like a crank a wheel to open a thing up, and the wheel had like skin-based drugs on it?
Yeah. Then they added in this realization that, the Wolf of Wall Street guy, that it was his friend and him that were on the boat. He actually murdered his friend so that he could survive, which, okay. I mean, again, they were just trying to like sell the heel turn on this.
Hey, how did they know that? They didn't know. How could you know that there's two people on a boat that is away from everyone else? How would you know that?
Well, he said he told the police that. When they found
him. No, he told police they swam away.
Well, no, I know that, but he said that's why there's two people. But then...
Yeah.
But then the guy who's on drugs now figured this out.
But the point of them getting him in the game was that they knew he murdered the guy. That was kind of the whole point.
Well, no, they didn't know. They just knew that he just survived.
Yeah. Soul survivor from two people. They assumed he murdered the guy.
No, they didn't.
Yeah, they did.
Everyone else
is a soul survivor for like 100 million people or whatever, and this guy was two people? No, they knew he was a murderer. That was kind of the whole point, I thought.
No? I think that was just supposed to be some random I think it was just shoehorned in there so that you felt better about them, like him getting like murdered by the grocery store.
Yeah, he got thrown really hard into his neck, into like a low part of a ceiling.
I don't know, because it was all really trippy and everything's melting.
Can we agree? Oh, Lisa, explain how he died. I don't know how it happened.
Yeah, he got hit the back of his skull broken open.
Yeah, but like, what was this room shape?
He hit it on the corner of something.
Well, what is this room shape that the corner of something is like,
I don't know,
5'10" in the air? Oh, God.
I don't know.
God.
But anyway, so he injects himself with the
antidote. Hashtag drug room.
Drugs are bad. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, so he injects himself with the antidote. He survives. Yay. He gets to the victory room.
Grocery guy.
Groceries. Yes. Yeah. And then he basically finds out that if you saw Unfriended Dark Web, basically, yeah, that's the same fucking
this
twist.
This is Saw meets Unfriended Dark Web. Yeah. Yeah, this is the same thing.
Everyone, basically people are watching and bidding on this.
It's like Nerve also, if you watch Nerve at all.
Yeah.
Did you watch Nerve?
No. Just so I can move past. Just so I can move past everything. You call
James Franco. James Franco. Come on. Dave Franco.
Shit. Well, that's why.
The lesser Franco. Yeah. I apologize. Yeah, I apologize for that.
He finds out, and then the game master that's been running the thing basically starts trying to strangle him.
Yeah, with like a Grotwire hitman style.
Yep. But then the scoreboard changes. I don't know how, because I don't know who's running the damn scoreboard. Zoe is alive.
Because she...
And she somehow...
She knows about quantum physics. Okay?
Kill the cameras.
Yeah. Her
she knows about quantum physics, and she knows that oxygen stops poison. What?
Yes.
Hello.
This was fucking stupid.
It was so easy to predict, and so terrible. Lisa, did you know this was happening from the get-go?
When she was thinking things out.
No, you know she wasn't dead?
No.
You didn't know that?
Well, when the first inklings, when they're like, oh, there's an oxygen mask, I was like, oh, she's alive.
Exactly. That was early in that room, by the way. No?
No, when the cleanup crew came in.
No, but you saw the oxygen mask earlier in the room.
Yeah, but...
Oh, okay.
I don't think she got... Yeah.
Oh, I got earlier than you. Oh, what?
No, I was with you. I caught it when they were doing the room, like, and she's like, she's poison. She ain't poison. She's fine. She comes back. She gets a gun after murdering the other two cleanup guys. And then
for a 110-pound woman.
And then, yeah, right. And then she misses shooting the dude horribly when she's like 5 feet away from him.
That's it. Yeah.
So
she's more of a, what is the thing called that holds the IV bags that you walk around with? She's really good with the IV pole. Terrible with guns, apparently.
Well, that's from her Shaolin monk days, where she was training with a bow staff, swinging it around. Who knows, man?
Crouching tiger, hidden ADHD.
Listen, that's part of the quantum physics curriculum. Now, she was already an advanced student, but you know, your entry classes into that major are, you know, rudimentary.
If you look at the bullet, it's not there anymore. That's what everyone.
Maybe because, before the plane crash, she was working on. She was wanting to become a stripper, and then after the plane crash, where her mom died, she's like, "No, I'm going to college now."
Yeah,
who knows? She was very good with the IV pole.
I'm in love with a stripper, unless you look at my love, in which case it's undefinable.
Oh my god. So they escape, and then years later, they decide that her and Grocery Boy escape. They somehow...
It's not years later. It's 6 months later.
Is it only 6 months? Who knows?
Calm down there.
Either way, she has been still investigating, and now she's going to go after the game designer.
She's got a Mission Impossible Rogue Nation level board with all the newspaper clippings and all that shit.
No, she doesn't. She has a scrapbook.
Well, at one point it was on a wall with a lot of yarn, and then it went into a scrapbook once she knew what was happening.
Maybe I was checking my phone at this point. I only saw the scrapbook, which good scrapbooking skills. Let's at least say that.
Yeah.
And then, of course, the game designer, you see him working on his next escape room, which is the airplane, and he knows that they're coming.
Because she figured out they had an address in New York City, and they're in Chicago, the best city in the world, and instead of taking trains, they take an airplane. Take trains.
Yeah.
Unless you saw Commuter, in which case, take trains.
I mean, this is almost like Battle Royale 2. It's the same sort of like...
But then, if you saw Commuter, you obviously saw Nonstop, so don't take planes either. So take trains.
Look,
It's snakes. There's no snakes on a train. And first of all, there probably is, and I apologize for the ripoff movie that occurred on.
Yeah.
But there are snakes on planes, and there are not snakes on trains, usually.
Yeah. It just was very reminiscent of Battle Royale, Battle Royale 2. They get out, they survive the game, and now the game masters are coming after them with a more difficult game. Okay.
Yeah, basically.
That's the movie.
Yeah.
That
they tested an airplane thing with some tests.
What did y'all think of the end? What did you think of the ending?
The ending sucked ballsack.
You know what I was really hoping?
It was hard.
What would you have rather
and
seen?
And there was the whole part where they do like the, they, in like 2 hours, they like took down a whole fucking building and like had no traces.
Oh, yeah.
Fuck that. Are you fucking kidding me? That's
garbage. I was hoping that the guy that took her back, you know, to like show her the place.
Was part of it.
Was Dr. Wu-Tang.
Yeah.
Wu-Tang Yu.
It wasn't. Mm. They're just incompetent and they can apparently take it on a whole high rise in like 3 seconds.
I thought that was going to be part of it and then they were going to lock her in. And that would
Thought they were going to put her like this insane asylum.
I have the sequel.
Like escape the room, but she's a psychiatrist.
The sequel is escape room. Lock in.
Yeah.
like, yeah. Remember when you were a little kid and lock in was cool? Nope, not anymore.
Then it would turn into insane.
Yeah, exactly. The ending sucked. Can we agree the ending ruined the movie?
Yeah.
Or
I don't know.
Lessened the impact of the movie, I think. Right?
I would have been fine with...
She escaped and that's it.
Yeah. I would have been fine with them just limping away when they're leaving. And that's it.
Yeah, and then maybe a little thing about that. You could leave... I'm fine if you leave in the trail of the game designer going... Let's go back again.
Sure,
you
know? There's kind of a thing going here, but not that specific. It really got just too ridiculous. Yeah. Not a fan.
Yeah. I'll tell you, the game designer was very quick to put that picture of the game master on like the survivors board. He had that queued up, ready to go. Yeah. I mean, well done.
Don't count your failures for this song. That's the
all right. So
there.
We're going to now it's a new year.
Oh, 2019.
So
2019 is the year of escape room. First horror movie of the year.
That's right.
It is now the escape room year. Like the year of the goat, the year of the dragon, whatever that shit is in China. This is the escape room year.
No.
Yeah, it too late.
When does It Part 2 come out?
Nope, too late.
This
too
year.
Late. Yeah, that's in June or whatever, July. Yeah. Too late.
All right, so look, this year... You know, we bring in a lot of a lot of the unsuspecting victims are our close friends. We do have special guests and we're hoping to have a lot more this year. But you know, one of the things we've always heard is from our friends after we record is, this is terrible. Why do you do this to us? So, you know, this year we're going to try to help. We want to try to help our unsuspecting victims be more optimistic about this. So this segment is now called It Could Be Worse.
Could be worse.
Not that bad.
For me, it's all about perspective. It's what you make of it.
Lisa, are you excited for this new segment?
Yeah. Our friends, I'm putting air, no
how could
air
it
quotes.
Be any worse?
No, in my air quotes, but friends think that we should be more upbeat. So, so now,
yeah,
here
those
you go.
Friends.
It could be worse.
So, Lisa, they're in this situation. You imagine you are in this movie with them.
Yeah.
How are you going to keep morale up?
Say you're the guy who didn't die. Like you're the good escape room person who like wasn't an idiot. How could it be worse for you?
Yeah.
It could be worse. This is hilarious.
Honestly, I don't know.
And it can't be more than just, you know, I could be dead.
Yeah. That's a little too easy.
I mean, what if he had lost his job at the grocery store?
Wow. I lost my job at the grocery store and I get a
fucking
puzzle.
What if they all got fired?
They all got fired.
And that was your motivation for the 10,000.
Everyone got fired from their job and then came to the play.
That's why they wanted the 10 grand.
It could be worse.
It could be worse.
Wow.
Yeah, he could have gotten blamed for all the murders.
No. First of all, hers is way better than yours.
I got bodied early. Thank you, Lisa.
What was yours?
I don't even know.
Doesn't matter.
I got bodied.
It could be worse. I'm gonna say this. The billiard room that was upside down
Yeah.
could have been right side up. Think about this. If the room is nothing on this, think about this, bitch.
Does the ceiling just drop on you?
No. If it's right side up and the bottom falls out and you're there, that is 10 times more embarrassing than if it's upside down and you fall through. Think about this. If you're standing on a thing and you know that the sound of the music ends and something drops out.
Yeah, but then you'd have no chance because there'd be nothing to climb up on.
There's all kinds of shit to climb up. There's all kinds of shit everywhere. But if you fell and
you'd
it was
you'd only
right,
be able to climb up on stuff that was mounted to the wall, though.
Exactly. But there's all kinds of climbing shit everywhere. There's climbing. There's like a whole bar. There's a whole like.
Yeah, but all of that.
Jukebox,
if they
all kind of shit.
It back, that yeah. would all fall with the floor.
No, it wouldn't. Not with the floor. It was on the outside of the wall. It was on the wall, not the floor.
So you're saying that it was mounted to the wall.
Exactly. If you fall and it's the floor, that's fucking embarrassing.
Like I think it was still embarrassing.
That's embarrassing. That's embarrassing.
Yeah.
If you're upside down, you're disoriented. If you're right side up and you fall through the floor at that point, that's on you, man. That's on you.
I'm just, for me, I'll say if it could be worse. You could have walked into that room, the waiting room.
Mitch, you already shanked your, it could be worse, but that's fine.
Shut your face. Shut your face.
You already shanked that. Go ahead.
What if you walked in there and the other five people are like, I don't know, it's R. Kelly.
Oh my God.
It's that, God. It's Mitch, pop, Mitch, it's that Mitch, poppy girl
Mitch,
or whatever.
Mitch. I want to piss on you right now.
Like, but he didn't try to piss on the fire. He might have been helpful.
Yeah, no. No, he wouldn't. No, he wouldn't.
I mean, yeah, just the worst people imaginable in that room. Roseanne Barr sitting in there with R. Kelly, wow. Poppy.
Compared to R. Kelly, Roseanne Barr's looking pretty great right now.
I just think more. It's, yeah, I don't know. I'm just saying the worst people you could think of are in that room with you. That's all.
We get it. R. Kelly should have fallen through the ice. I understand, but yikes. I like Lisa's.
What if he was trapped? What if one of the rooms was then trapped in the closet and you're just all in the closet?
Yeah. Yeah. You know what? He wouldn't get out. He's worthless. The guy's worthless.
The problem is you'd be trying to get out and he'd be rapping about it.
Exactly.
And it's just like that song, just like the Trapped in the Closet song. He's like just walking
trapped
through.
Trapped in the Closet is like a part 18, like 18
parts. Well, yeah,
parts
but the whole song is like, he's just going like, here's everything that happened. So he's just rapping about all the stuff you're trying to do to get out of the closet.
And I just want to thank our friend Tim for fucking up our lives for showing me those videos.
Yeah. And then he grabbed the key.
Yeah. Like a part 38 of 100 million or something. God damn it.
Yeah, that was a really bad New Year's
Eve. Now we have we have another new segment.
Yes.
Year.
So
instead of our sequel pitch, which was a good segment, if I might say so. And if you still like it, let us know at textpodcastmassacre@gmail.com and TXPodMassacre on Twitter and Facebook and Instagram, all the platforms. But this year, instead of pitching a sequel, each of us, I'm going to spin the wheel of genres. Mitch coined that. So if you hate it, it's Mitch's fault. Yep. And we're gonna try to make a movie in the genre of that.
So
we're
repitching this movie in the genre.
Escape room of what genre?
Spin the wheel, Nate.
So the wheel is being spun. Escape room as a Western.
Oh my gosh.
Escape room as a Western. Mitch, what do you have here?
Yeah, so let's all workshop this one together.
Wow, wow, wow.
Yeah, so.
Wow, wow, wow.
I don't. How would you do this as a Western?
As a Western. Think about this.
We have done a Western themed escape room. We've done two.
Oh, okay. Here we go. Here we
so
go.
So would you do a kind of Westworld esque? Like would you be? Oh, would you?
There
would
we
the
go.
Room be in the Wild Wild West kind of thing? And you had your avatars, and there was
only if the Will Smith song is playing over and over again.
Oh Jesus!
First of all, I just want to say I know this. I know that
giant
song.
Mechanical.
I know
spider.
That song by heart through and through.
That is not something to be proud
at
of.
At our friend David's immigration or citizenship party, I sang this song all the way through with accompaniment, and it was well received. So I just want to
well
throw
received.
That out there. I just want to Jeez. Throw that out there ahead of time. Now, once upon a time in the mist.
No, we're man, no, stop it. I will get the water, the little spray bottle, and spray you.
I'll put your behind to the test in the shadows, ready to battle. Oh my God. I can go forever. All right, so Will Smith related. So no, you're not done with this yet. You're not done with this yet. Your escape room is, first of all, Wild Wild West, the movie themed or the TV show? TV show from the 60s, I'm a huge fan of.
No, the movie.
That's worse.
The movie seems worse.
That's fine. The worst. That's fine. Yeah. So Will Smith.
Giant mechanical. Was it a spider?
Yeah, it was a giant mechanical spider from Dr. Arliss Loveless, which is, first of all, it should be Miguelito Loveless. They shanked that also, but that's fine. So a mechanical spider escape room with Will Smith related.
Yeah.
This is what we're talking about. That's your whole premise?
Yeah.
That's good.
I got nothing better than that. I mean, that's a solid Western. What if the game designer is John Wayne?
He is dead.
Or is he?
Didn't stop him from Philip Seymour Hoffman in Hunger Games. That's true.
Yeah.
Okay. So you have a Tupac CG, Tupac hologram, John Wayne making a movie about what?
No, I think all the escape rooms, it's the same thing, but all the rooms are different classic Westerns. So one's like a Dirty Harry room. One's
that's not a Western. That's fine.
That's fine. I don't know Western.
Mitch, I'm gonna stop you right there.
This has been a,
Who is the ultimate Western person who's still alive?
Clint Eastwood.
Does Clint Eastwood direct movies?
Yes.
Like The Mule that just came out? Yes. Was The Mule good? Debatable. But he's directed movies. Clint Eastwood directs Escape the West. He stars and directs in a movie in which he is the crotchety old man who gives the clues to the people to escape this Western ghost town.
So he's the game master?
Exactly.
What?
He's acting, directing, and writing of this.
Nate.
Yes.
We missed it. Missed the low-hanging fruit.
What's that?
Escape room, the Oregon Trail. The fucking Oregon Trail.
Mitch, gang. There's no rooms there.
No, but you could die of dysentery.
In a ghost town, there are actually rooms.
What?
You can use.
Water is vitally important.
Water is vitally important.
Yeah. Mitch's idea died of dysentery. That's all I got to say. That's all I got to say there.
Yeah. All right. Well, look.
Bradley Cooper is the main, actor.
We are at that point in the episode. There. Nate, Lisa, let me hear your final cuts.
Final cut.
Nate, why don't you kick us off?
So this movie was not great. The rooms.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, this is what I hate about movies. Mitch, we have two pet. You and I have a pet peeve together. Time travel. Time loops.
Yeah.
That's garbage. Time travel one direction like Terminator, I'm okay with. Time loops a la Castle Rock. Fuck that shit.
Okay.
Can we agree on this?
Largely, yeah.
Another pet peeve I have is you show the
Terminator time travel. I'm okay with.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Yeah.
But if you have strict rules and you're adhering.
But the loop shit, fuck that. Yeah. The loop, it gets insane. Yep. If another pet peeve I have is if you start a movie like with the cool part and then go back like a certain amount of time and then get to the cool part again, like, why did you show me the cool part in the beginning? Like, you're fucking with everything.
Yeah.
Which this movie does in the very beginning, right? With that map room or whatever it was called, right?
Yeah.
So it's hitting on some of my pet peeves. The actors, and I'm putting air quotes. No one can see my air quotes, but actors is generous in this, are not good. They're two-dimensional stereotypes at best. Plus points for Chicago. That's my main plus points.
All your points are for Chicago.
All my points are for Chicago, Rep Chi Town. But I'm going to say that I'm going to give this movie a 4 out of 10 Chicago River boat rides. Because
I was hoping you're going to go Geno's. Yeah,
but I say 4 out of 10. This movie is getting a franchise.
Oh, yeah.
It did well.
It'll get maybe a trilogy.
It doubled its budget in one weekend. Yeah, it's getting a fucking franchise. It's getting a franchise. Mm. And I hope they're all in Chicago. If they're all in Chicago, I might still go to them.
God. Yeah, I agree with you. I will say this wasn't as egregious, but I agree with your criticism of why are you showing me something that's going to happen later? I would have rather. Like, I didn't mind them opening up with an escape room thing.
Like, imagine you were in an escape room and like they showed you three rooms ahead. Like, that sucks. Like, why would you ever do that escape room? Right?
I would have rather just seen just someone completely not associated with the main six. And he died, you know, you just see. And
yeah,
that's
as a
that's
test. Fine. Yeah. As a test. Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Yeah. But no, they didn't do that.
Yeah. It's okay. The puzzles are fine. I mean, it's harder if you escape room and not talk about the.
Well, no. I want to hear a separate rating from you guys. Puzzle level. You guys are obviously done a lot of escape rooms. How good were the puzzles? Were they hard enough? Were they interesting?
Well, I
want to hear that kind of opinion.
Here. I'd give that a 6 out of 10.
Okay.
If only because some of the rooms were great, but some of the rooms were also terrible.
What do you think, Lisa?
Yeah, 6 or 7. There's a few of the, like we said, the billiard room puzzle was on point. The one puzzle that they showed at the very beginning.
With the hands.
Yeah.
And he has to move like the digits. Okay,
and we've done a million of those stupid maze things.
Yeah, 4 numbers out of 10 to kind of move on this little path on the
so
wood.
So there were a few puzzles that we liked, and then there were just some that were dumb.
Yeah, but largely this movie is nothing you haven't seen. There's no real tension or scares, in my opinion.
Scares are almost zero.
Yeah. And there's no real gore. So if you're not a gore fan, you'll prefer this over Saw.
It's Saw light.
Yeah, this is Saw for kids. I'm around you. I give it 5 out of 10 combo locks.
Okay. So Lisa, as I expect the victim, not a lot of gore. There were deaths, but they were kind of like weak deaths.
Off camera
falling, like one guy got his neck snapped pretty nicely, but generally kind of like under the ice, there's not a whole lot of, was that a positive for you? Were the, like the off screen, like, was it, was there any scares of any kind? I assume no, but I don't want to.
No, I mean, it was sad that they died, but it wasn't scary. Like, I didn't come home and lay awake going, oh my God.
Yeah.
That was horrible.
The ice exploded. Oh,
so
no.
if you are yourself an unsuspecting victim, you would say this is a fine movie to watch. If you had to watch a horror movie.
Is this unsuspecting victim approved?
Yeah.
No, it was a terrible movie. Could you handle it? Sure.
Yeah. Okay, so yes, but no.
Yeah.
Yes, okay. But no.
So out of 10, what do you got here then? Final cut.
I'm like right in between you guys. I'm debating. I don't know. Maybe a 5, just because I did like some of the puzzles, and it kind of gets me in the feels because we've done so many escape
rooms. So 5 out of 10 what?
5 out of 10, you said combo locks. What did you say?
Chicago River Cruises.
Oh. I don't know why you think it rep Chi-Town so much. They didn't even show any of Chicago.
They showed the river. They showed a cruise. That's why I got the thing.
For about 10 seconds.
Doesn't matter. Got it.
There was nothing.
Chi-Town.
Like, Wasso's, you know, panoramic scenes of San Francisco.
Yeah, but the movie didn't have like 30 minutes of pans across the city.
So Lisa, 5 out of 10 what?
5 out of 10.
Chicago hot dogs. I'm just kidding.
Gosh, I don't even know. 5 out of 10 unsuspecting victims.
Oh, wow. Okay, she's personifying.
They were all unsuspecting victims.
Personifying herself, okay.
All right, well, that is going to wrap it up for this week. Nate, where can they find us?
Yeah, so you can find us at our website, texaspodcastmassacre.com, on Twitter, at TXPodMassacre. Check us out on Instagram, Facebook, all of the podcast platforms. There's a lot of them. We appreciate all of your responses, and it's 2019. We made a New Year's resolution that we're going to respond to as many of your comments and reviews and feedback as possible. So keep them coming. Keep the emails coming. And we'll answer, and it'll be great.
Yep. C's and P's, Nate.
I fucking hate that. God damn it.
Well, from all of us here at Texas Podcast Massacre, thank you so much for tuning in. And just keep telling yourself, it's only a movie. Good night.